Hey, High Levelers, Rayo Daniel here. I'm here to give you another great feature release from a High Level platform, and that is the new tool called Brand Voice. Now, as High Level continues to expand and grow its AI system and really build out its AI infrastructure inside of the Go High Level platform, one of the things that they've noticed and other people have complained about, at least on the boards, are being able to be consistent across all the types of communication that you have. So if you've ever gone into the settings inside of AI for like content AI or even conversation AI, programming the AI chatbot, you have to give it a tone of how do you want it to respond, how you want it to be, if you're writing a blog article, what type of tone do you want, professional, friendly, things like that. So how does all of that stuff get centralized? How does it pull from one central place instead of having to program each and every component every time you want to use the AI system? How do you do that? Highlevel has come up with this new feature called Brand Voice, which allows you to have one place to configure all of these settings and have it choose that option wherever you're at inside of the platform. Let's hop in and take a look. So here we've got our DigiGlobal agency. This is one of my famous test accounts that I have. And what I want to do is come down here and show you this new feature. It's under marketing and it's actually under brand boards. Now, if you remember several months ago, I did release a video called Brand Boards, where basically High Level allows you to keep all of certain types of colors and fonts and things like that regarding your brand all in one particular spot. So you don't have, if you're inside the funnel AI, if you're inside some of these other places, you don't have to keep going out and looking for custom colors and things like that all the time. You could just go to your brand colors and choose those, making it a lot easier to get these things done. They've included the brand voice inside of the same configuration part as brand boards. Now, I do want to give you this little caveat. Brand voice is still something relatively new. I do not believe it's been completely integrated into every platform that or every AI system yet. I'm going to show you where it's integrated and how you choose it. But if you've ever been dealing with anything regarding conversation AI recently, you're going to realize that you're going to have to select a brand voice first before you can use conversation AI, at least the new bots inside of High Level. So let's hop in here and take a quick look. This is the brand voice. Now, I've already created one and kind of built it out, and I'm going to go over that. But right now, what I want to do is just kind of show you what a new one would look like. So right now, we do have this start from scratch and then this text or URL. To be quite honestly, I couldn't find anything on the text or URL about why you would want to do this or pull this stuff in, so I'm not going to go over it because quite honestly, I don't know. So I'm just going to go ahead and select the start from scratch. Now, what this is going to do is going to give you the ability to sit back and look at all the information, first of all, that the brand voice can contain. Now, out of all of this, keep in mind, you can have multiple brand voices, okay? So you can have one brand voice for certain types of things that you do in email marketing, and then another brand voice that you use to do things like inside a social planner to create content inside of it. So keep that in mind. You can have different, again, voices or programming involved with this. So you can have as many of these as you want, but again, only one of them is set as default. So here we just have the business name, the brand name, the business type. So this is just a list of what kind of business it is. And again, keep in mind that all of this is just giving AI the ability to give you a more well-rounded idea of what your business is, what type of business, your website. So it can go out and look at your website, company email address and addresses and phone numbers and things like that. So we can integrate that into the text if necessary. But let's take a quick look here. This is all basic information now. To be quite honest, I really would wish it'd be like a link here where you could just say pull information from the existing sub account and not have to type it all in, but I guess that might be on a future release. So here we go, location, company information, address, phone number, business hours. Again, very generic type things that you always have. Here's where you can actually select your voice here. Again, this would be the voice type for or the tone for this particular brand voice. Okay, so you can make it whatever you want. I'm just going to make it friendly. Now, here's some of the things that I really want to make sure that we look over here, and I'm going to go over in depth some of these settings in the one I've already done because I don't want to take you through the whole process I did. It took me probably 20-30 minutes to go through all that, and I'll explain it when I get there to the other brand voice. But your target audience. Notice that High Level is really good about sitting back and just saying, describe your ideal audience. Young professionals, small business owners. So give it an idea. What is this brand voice targeting? What is it that you're trying to do here? And again, this is going to be completely up to your business. I don't know who you're targeting or anything like that, but you can, again, create multiple brand voices targeting multiple audiences and then using different tones for each one of those. So that's very important. So right now, some of the customer pain points, describe the problems that frustrations the audience face. Okay. Now keep in mind, these are a couple that are red starred. So these have to be done. So those are two things that, at least from this perspective, the target audience and the customer pain point that has to be done. Some of these other ones don't have to be, they're not required. But if you ever have something, this is where you can do brand promise. Summarize how your brand benefits your audience. So again, why you? Brand values. This is where it's like a negative here. This has threw me off a bit, but identify some of the brand that it does not compromise on. So it almost wants you to do a negative here on it. So don't tell me what you are going to give me. Tell me what you're not looking to give your customer. And again, that's an interesting point. So be careful here. So again, highlight what your brand opposes. Poor customer service, inefficiency, things like that. So just be careful on this one. You don't want to do the opposite because it could have a negative effect when AI tries to generate that based upon how Highlevel built these brand voices. What does your brand do? Again, what do you offer? What is your 30-second elevator pitch? If you had to sit back and pitch somebody about your brands or services, what is it that you do? And I'm going to give you, I'm going through these quick and I'm going to save this one, but I'm going to go back and go spend some time with the other brand voices I've created. And feel free, you can copy it, steal everything I've got in the other one, because I did take a little bit of time with ChatGPT to really fine tune those responses and make it better for you. So what makes you better than your competitors? Again, what's your biggest advantage? Again, it talks about better pricing, superior customer service, exclusive features, all in one platform. See, those type of things. Unique selling proposition. I won't go over all of them here. State what makes your brand stands out. Risk of inaction. What happens if you don't accept my offer? What happens if you continue to let your business go without accepting my offer? What happens? And it comes up with things like lost time, higher costs, missed opportunities. Again, yeah, missed customers, less revenue, things like that. And then finally, what is a call to action? What happened? What is it that you hope to do in the end of the conversation for this? Go book an appointment, click here to fill out a contact form. What is it that you're looking for? And actually give direction for that. So right now what I'm doing is I'm going to come back in here and I'm going to just label this real quick. I'm just going to call it BV1, Brand Voice 1. And I'm just going to save it, of course. And I want to sit back and get that's not required. That's not required. None of these things are required. Friendly target audience, small business owners. I'm not going to use this one, so I don't really care. Customer pain points. I'll just say overwork. So right now, let me go ahead and click on save. I just want to save the brand voice so we have more than one. Whenever we get to the parts where we look into the brand voices, we can actually see how you could select a different brand voice depending upon where you're at inside of the AI platform, how you can select different options here. But I need more than one to do that. So let's hop into this Digi Global Agency, the one that I've already built here and got it set as default. So here I've already filled all this stuff out here. There is a website. I do have this live and up just on a public website for demonstration purposes. But here's some of the things that I just helped ChatGPT help me generate here. So the target audience, business owners who need help answering calls, replying to reviews, and booking clients automatically. Okay. Customer pain points. Many business owners miss calls, lose leads after hours, struggle to reply to reviews, can't keep up with website inquiries, and can't afford to hire help or even find good help. So again, pain points, brand promise, turn every missed call, revenue, or review and website visitor into a customer automatically. And you can adjust all these, but you get the point here. What is it that you're promising? Now, here's the one that's like negative. What is your brand not compromise on? Poor customer service, missing calls, not answering customer inquiries. And you can go on and on, add as many of these as you want. And all it does is help give and fine tune the AI responses when it uses your brand voice. So again, what does your brand do? We help small business owners automate customer communication with AI, our AI employee calls 24/7, you could read it. But that's it again, what does your brand do? What makes you better than your competition? All in one platform, speed of implementation, scalability to grow your business. So all of these are benefits. Again, with AI, if you're using the AI implemented inside of here, especially if you're using my AI snapshot that I've actually created here, and I'll put a link to it in the description here below if you're interested. And if you do, I actually recorded an AI masterclass, by the way, a little bit of information, an AI masterclass with Highlevel. And if you do attend and get signed up through there, you'll also get my AI snapshot there that has a ton of stuff in there. Check out my other video I did on my website with the AI snapshot to see if that's something you're interested in. What's your unique selling proposition? Use one or more powerful platforms to handle calls, chat, booking, the reviews, blah, blah, blah. So that's what we do. Risk of inaction, lost customers, missed business opportunities, less revenue, more wasted time doing repetitive tasks. And then finally, call to action, schedule a quick discovery call to see how our AI services can transform your business at, and then give it the actual link, if you can, to your website and to book a call so that anytime you're generating text, then that link can be embedded. It could be, they could put the whole link, they could just say, click here, discover a call, something like that. But AI can use that link to do a discovery call session for you. So that's the things that you can do inside of a brand voice. Now, again, this is primarily what I wanted to show you here is just what the brand voice is, what you can configure, the type of settings that you would configure it. Now, I'm going to spend briefly a little bit of time just kind of showing where these brand voices pop up. Where are you likely to see that? Now, first of all, if you're going to be using conversation AI, which I'm not going to go into this, I'm going to be doing another updated video where I go over conversation AI in general, more specifically with using the brand voice to configure and communicate with that, as well as knowledge bases. And I know I haven't covered that, but that's another new feature Highlevel's release as well. All that'll be in another video. But here, I'm just trying to show you the basics of the brand voice, where it can be used and so forth. So here, if we go and click create bot, notice we've got two different kinds. I'm just going to choose general Q&A. If we do this, notice one of the very first things in the wizard, brand voice. You have to select a brand voice for this Because again, the brand voice is really a way to standardize all the written communications that Highlevel has inside of the platform. So again, it's for technically they're trying to focus on writing languages. So in when you're creating a conversation AI, this goes back to the tone of how you want to respond back to people on your live chat widget or your website chat widget, or maybe you create a different brand voice for social media. Okay. So you might want to do something different if you're doing a social media post. So you're responding in conversation AI, you've got the Facebook and the Instagram integration for that one. You could select a different brand voice for your social media than you do your website. You might set that up, but that's something that you could do. And that's, I believe, the reason why Highlevel didn't like this is to sit back and allow you to actually program this particular bot with a certain tone of how you wanted to respond to customers. And then on top of that, once it has its tone, that doesn't mean that you still don't have to program the bot. And again, I'll go over that in another video sometime here. But the brand voice, once you hit through this, go ahead and click next. You see, now you get to the bot settings, which is like the, what you're used to. But basically, here's the biggest thing. The brand voice comes up first. So you have to create at least one brand voice for using conversation AI. So again, because conversation AI is text, it's written communication through Highlevel, which is what the brand voice was created for. Now, speaking of written communication, emails, email marketing, I'm just going to show you here in a template. I'm going to open up this older newsletter thing that I was working on a long time ago. So I'm coming down here just to the text area. And then I'm going to come over here and click on this little AI button here. This is where you would click to engage AI here instead of the email editor, generate with AI. Now notice you get this nice little toggle switch, use brand voice. If you don't want to use the brand voice for this, then you don't need to. You could just use, turn that off. But notice in brand voice, now you could select, this is where I wanted to have two of them to select from. You could use it the default, which is just going to be the one that's selected by default. Or I could switch it to a different one if I wanted to use a different brand voice to generate text in the email marketing that you do. Your emails might want to be funny. Your website, or this default agency, is professional, for example. So that's where you would separate the tone of the emails out by just choosing that differently on the brand voices. So anyway, I'm not going to go over creating all the stuff. I just want to show you, this is where, if you've been in here, this is where you'll see that at. The same thing is inside of the social planner, as well as inside of any of the other stuff. If you go to blogs, inside of the blogs, again, blogs are a little bit differently here. If you click on this, I believe we do have a blog site set up here. So if we do this and then go and edit like one of these other blogs that I've created here, it's in a little bit of a different place here. This is where the AI is inside of the blog article, but notice the brand voice pops up. So the Highlevel has been really good about being consistent across there. And the same way, just with any place where you're writing and stuff like that, that you actually have those brand voices. So hopefully this gives you a good idea of what a brand voice is, why you configure it, the type of settings that you would want to put in, and maybe why you would want to select multiple different brand voices for different types of bots or communications that you may have with either email, your social planner, your blog posts, and conversation AI, different channels that you've got. You might want to have different tones on those as well. So if you enjoyed this, if you learned something, smash the like button, leave me a comment. As always, I appreciate you following me on YouTube. You guys have a great day. Bye-bye.